So I'm back here, and of course the Hawks, Whitehawk FC. They're stone dead bottom of the table at the moment. Even a win here today, in which they're playing against Dorking, who are high flying, let's be honest. Even a win won't see them reach above the bottom of the table. They will still stay stone dead bottom. They do need to build some momentum. Let's see what happens. It's going to be a tricky game here today. Spoke to a couple of Dorking supporters just a minute ago.
It's going to be 3-0 to Dorking, mate.
Is it?
There's no two ways about it. And I think the two sides are a class apart.
Yeah.
Okay. The Greens are going to have it.
Let's hope that's not going to be the case. And of course, the Hawks, they played against Worthing in a local derby last week, where they lost 2-1. So that was a bit of a difficult pill to swallow, not just because it was a local derby, but they did have a chance actually to equalise at the end of the game. But we'll see what happens. This is my second visit to Whitehawk. And within the opening 30 seconds, Dorking had a chance there. This is not going to be fun, I don't think, today. What's going on?
Well, it's 0-0 at the moment, and there's a little bit of tension in the air. You know, I think we've had a couple of good chances, but we could desperately do with some points today.
Playing Dorking, high flyers.
Yeah, you know, good side.
Once top of the league this season.
Yeah, and they've done pretty well so far this season. Come down here for the first time in a while, and it'd be interesting to see how we get on. We played well last Tuesday against Worthing. Very unlucky not to win.
That was a shame, that.
Yeah, really unlucky not to win. But when you're at this, you know, at the bottom, it just doesn't go for you. So, you know, we'll see how it goes.
They need to build a bit of consistency. But a win here today against such a top side would really put them in good stead and will hopefully give them that momentum to carry forward.
Yeah, it's about confidence, you know.
It
I
is.
Don't mind if they win in the 95th minute off someone's kneecap, you know. Absolutely fine, from about two inches out.
Still shouting, still they're loving it.
Still giving it,
enjoying it, aren't they?
Still banging the drums, and I think that's astonishing. You know, we're bottom of the league by some distance, and they're still here, and they're still giving it all the support. You know.
Another free kick to the Hawks. Way over. Not the greatest free kick in the world. They're holding their own, though, it must be said. A good 20 minutes into the game now, and they're doing pretty well. They're remaining strong and firm, and I think that Whitehawk are testing the patience of Dorking. I think Dorking are getting a little bit antsy with what's going on. A couple of fouls. There's a yellow card that's just been dished out, actually. It's one of the Dorking players. So it's actually quite a good start, I think. So it's 0-0 here at half time, and must be said, the Hawks have done well. They've put the pressure on, and they frustrated Dorking throughout most of the first half. If they could do that in the second half, to get a 0-0 draw, would be a good result for the Hawks, I think. Though, of course, they do need a win. But whether they're going to get it against a high-flying Dorking side, not so sure. Starting to get dark here over Whitehawk FC. We've kicked off for the second half. Still 0-0. Hopefully it will remain that way if, of course, the Hawks don't get a goal. And we've switched sides over here, the din, as they call it. Our interviews never work very well. We're just talking about the din, which is what this is, basically. Why is it called a din? Explain.
You know what? I'm not actually too sure why it's called a din, and I'm not 100% sure.
Well, a din is sort of like noise, isn't it? But from the other end of the ground, it produces this kind of noise, and part of that is because of this kind of, I don't know, it's like scaffolding, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's got this sort of thing at the back.
Isn't it?
So not only do you have the drums, which kind of produce this echo via the iron, but we're just saying it must be quite unnerving for the goalkeeper of any opposing team that's standing there with this noise going on in the back of their heads.
Yeah.
And let's be honest, if that huge wall of noise for 45 minutes did happen to put off the goalkeeper that led to a mistake, I think we'd be quite happy with that. That is the epiphany of what a 12th man is all about, right?
Oh, definitely. We are definitely the 12th man here at Whitehall, without a doubt.
And look who I found up here. None other than Bill. How are you, Bill?
I'm fine, thank you. Actually, pretty good today.
Not bad, is it?
Yeah, doing all right.
A lot of Dorking fans thought they were going to run riot over Whitehawk. Had some saying that they thought it was going to be a 3-0 drabbing. Not been the case?
No, it's been pretty even, to be honest. We just lack a couple of really hot strikers. If we could get, Danny Mills back from Welling or, really just a great striker, then I think it would make a world of difference.
Yeah, I don't believe that Whitehawk have had any shot on target today.
No.
Okay, that was a bit unforeseen. What do you think? Whitehawk scored. You can hear the noise coming from the din.
That was really amazing, actually. Really good bit of play down the right wing to get the cross in, and a surefire finish. Tom here is just about to tell us who scored, I think, here on the announcing. Just here
let's,
we go.
Let's find out.
Nathaniel Pinney, number 9 centre forward, scored the goal.
Fantastic.
Great cross on the right.
It
Tom
really
will
was.
Probably tell you who it was.
Pinpoint.
Yeah.
Let's have a word with Tom.
Yeah.
Tom.
You are.
How are you?
I'm happier now.
You're happier.
Yeah.
So, 1-0. 1-0 the Hawks.
We'll see if we can hold it.
Do you think we can hold on to it?
We've defended well so far, so there's no reason why we couldn't.
What's your job here?
Media officer. There's two of us that do it.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, the other person who does media today is currently in the Amex for Liverpool versus Brighton.
Which we don't want to know about.
Yeah, no one cares about that one today. But yeah, at least we're winning.
It's brilliant. It's a brilliant goal.
It was.
Well set up. It was a good cross.
Rodriguez has been ripping them apart all day. He's been taking so much abuse from Dorking. So for him to get the assist and create the goal, fantastic. Yeah. Let's just see if we can hold it now.
Fingers crossed. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
I'm just about to come over and congratulate you on your lead. And in amongst the walk from over there to walking back here, an equaliser.
What can you say?
It's a good goal. It was a good goal from the Hawks. It was a good cross. Unfortunately, it was also an equally good goal from Dorking, I think.
No.
Well,
I think I might miss it in the celebrations of actually scoring a goal.
A couple more minutes to go. Still 1-1. This would be a big result, though, for the Hawks if they can hold on to this 1-1 draw. Very, very important point. Confidence-wise, it's not going to take them up the table at all. They're still going to be stone dead last in the bottom of the league. But for confidence purposes going forward, it's going to be a pretty useful point because they're going to think back to today's game where they held a team like Dorking. And that's it. End of the game. 1-1. Not bad. As per usual, the players saying thank you to their fans here at the Din. It ends 1-1. Good result for the Hawks. Good result. How did it go?
It was tough.
Good result. Good result.
It's a good episode.
It is. That's what you need. A bit of confidence going forward. So, a bit sweaty. And not unsurprisingly, because that was a hard-fought draw. Something that they did need. And as you said, a stepping stone for going forward. So, fingers crossed, they can build on that for the next game.